Do you know the real reason? They call him the Burger King. No, it's not because he likes burgers. No, most definitely is not. When the epidemic hit, when that first strike came, when those zombies, those aliens, those mutants first rolled into town, he woke up. No reason why. No reason to it. He woke up in a Burger King, drenched in sweat. Nothing but a Glock 18 drum mag in his hand. Surrounded by hundreds, some even say 1,000, of these brain, flesh, zombie, meat-driven creatures. They were drawn there by the meat, by the raw flesh. So, he knew one thing that he could do. The only thing he knew to get out of there. Just shoot and walk. Some say, through the miracle of God himself. Some say, from sheer emotion, will, love, and power. Some say, he embodied every single living creature known to bloody earth, known to humankind. And he walked those bloody tiles. He walked through that restaurant, and he took them all down. Just held the trigger, waved it around, just fought through the blood and flesh with sheer will and power. And somehow, through no miracle but his own strength and power, he crossed that threshold. And as he crossed it, he became a new man. His eyes dead, black and cold. His skin now soaked in not just sweat, but blood. He was driven by one thing, like those zombies back there. He was powered by one thing, like those zombies back there. He could think of only one thing, like those zombies back there. Survive. That's just what he did. As he strolled through that desolate car park, one of those little bloody spider looking things came up behind him, scurried up, leapt onto his back and dug its teeth right into his shoulder. Right in. But my man, this man, knew one thing, and one thing only. Survive. So, he turned the gun on himself, pressed it up against his shoulder blade, and pulled that trigger. That thing fell straight off his back, dead. Big hole in the middle on the ground. But you weren't the only thing with an old limb now. So. Now. You know the real reason why they called him the Burger King.
What we've got here is failure to communicate. Some men you just can't reach. So you get what we had here last week, which is the way he wants it. Well, he gets it. I don't like it.
Look at your women crying, look at your young men dying, the way they've always done before.